Hello aspirants, welcome to Law Excellence. Welcome to the session on Current Affairs for Beginners. In this session, I am going to tell you about the terms, concepts, schemes and institutions that appeared in today's newspaper, that is 12th July 2018. Let me give you answers for yesterday's questions. The first question is, Comprehensive Economic Partnership Agreement is sometimes seen in use in the context of Free Trade Agreement between India and China, Preferential Trade Agreement between India and South Korea, Free Trade Agreement between India-Singapore and Free Trade Agreement between India and Japan. In the comment section also, so many people tried the answer as B. But remember, it is not Preferential Trade Agreement. There is difference between Preferential Trade Agreement and Free Trade Agreement. We already discussed this. In Preferential Trade of Agreement, the agreement will be on selected basket of goods. And on this basket of goods, they will reduce the tariffs and non-tariff barriers. So, the answer is not B, it is D. Comprehensive Economic Partnership Agreement is a free trade agreement between India and South Korea and also between India and Japan. So, please read the answers carefully and try to avoid this type of mistakes. The second question is, consider the following statements regarding Wolbachia bacteria. It can help to reduce transmission of viruses like Zika and dengue. It can be used to suppress mosquito population by making the female Aedes aegypti sterile. This is not female, it's male mosquito sterile. So the answer is B, one only. The first statement is correct and the second statement is wrong. So the answer is B, one only. The first article is, Government leaves decision on section 377 to the court. We have discussed this section 377 in yesterday's videos, but my interest here is to say about this fundamental right, that is right to life. Before that, let me say, in our Indian constitution, we have parts, articles and schedules. In this parts, in the part 3, and from Article 12 to 35, we have fundamental rights. These rights are the rights to the citizens against the government. If the right of that citizen is violated, he or anyone on behalf of him, in some circumstances, can go and file in Supreme Court under Article 32, and he can go to even High Court under Article 226. And in this 12 to 35 articles, from 19 to 22, we call that articles as right to freedom. In that, we have Article 21, that is right to life and personal liberty. And this article, Article 21, it declares that no person shall be deprived of his life or personal liberty except according to the procedure established by law. Firstly, in Gopalan case, 1950, Supreme Court interpreted this right to life in a very narrow way. And it said, protection under this article is only against the arbitrary executive action and not from the arbitrary legislative action. But in Menaka case, 1978, it widened the scope of Article 21 and it said it included some rights, that is some 34 rights in this Article 21. Since this article right to life is in use from so many days, that is firstly in Aadhaar case and Puttuswamy case, they upheld this right to privacy, and after that right to privacy, they said it is an integral part of Article 21. And in so many issues, it was in news. So, from prelims perspective, we have to see all the inferred rights which come under Article 21, that 34 rights we have to see. And we also have to see that whether this right to privacy is given to citizens and it is also given to foreigners, or we have some enemy aliens, whether to these three people we will give this article or not. This we will give to citizens and also to foreigners. We don't give it to enemy aliens. and also try to see which of these fundamental rights, that is from 12 to 35, are available to citizens and foreigners. And the next article is Center Upholds Net Neutrality Proposals. In this article, we have to see what is this net neutrality. This is the principle that internet service providers and governments should treat all the data on the internet equally and should not discriminate or charge differently either by user or by content or by site, platform, application or type of the equipment they use or based on the mode of communication. That is, we have internet service providers who provide internet facility to all the users or any customers. And if there are some persons and they have their own websites, what this internet, that is what these internet service providers, they were doing is, if based on this content, or if this content is good or this content may get popular, they will give fast access to this website, and they don't give fast access to this website based on these differences they will see. And now government said you should treat all the persons equally, and this we call as net neutrality. It is treating all the data equally irrespective of user, content, site and application. The next article is Ancient Romans may have started commercial whaling. Here our interest is this Strait of Gibraltar from geography point of view. That is, in GS paper 1 we have geography, and also in prelims we have geography. In physical geography point of view, we have to see this Strait of Gibraltar. Firstly, we have to know what is this strait. A strait is a water body that is thin channel of waterway that connects two other large water bodies. Here, the Strait of Gibraltar connects Atlantic Ocean and Mediterranean Sea. And whenever any country is in news, try to see any water body or anything geographically important around that. For example, Hormuz Strait you have, that is Iran in news, Iran nuclear deal. You'll read many things about this Iran nuclear deal, but you don't see this Hormuz Strait, which separates Iran and UAE countries, and it joins Gulf of Oman and Persian Gulf. You have to see whether any country is in news, you have to see anything geographically important around that. The next article is Climate Change Threatens Nilagiri Tar. Here you have to see this IUCN. This was discussed already in previous videos, and it also releases a red data book. This also we have discussed. But my concern here is to say that if you can't read all the species that are, that comes under this 9 categories, that is extinct, extinct in wild, critically endangered, endangered, vulnerable, near threatened, least concern, data deficient and not evaluated. You can't read all the species that are listed here, but any species that is in news, that is today Nilgiri Tahar in news, you have to arrange this in this position. That is, here it is mentioned that endangered. So you have to make a table. Whenever any species come into use, you have to arrange it in your table that after 1 year it will be easy for you. And the second point is, they said climate change threatens Nilgiri Tar. So whenever they ask you question from GS paper 3, what are the impacts of climate change, you can add this point, that is environmental aspect, in that question. Next article is a difficult campaign. In this article, we have to see what is this Panama Papers and what is this Panama Papers leak. Normally, we'll have a LAFIMS. That is, any agent or individual or any company, to avoid taxes, they will say their information to this LAFIMS, and they will manage to avoid taxes by having some loopholes in the law, they will see some loopholes in this tax rules and they will avoid taxes. And we have a country called Panama in Central America. In that Panama country, we have a law firm called Mossack Fonseca. And in this law firm, so many people, that is around so many heads of states, around 12 to 60 people, they have shared their information, how they avoided taxes and what are the illegal activities they have made. All the information they have shared with this firm and another NGO, that is non-profit organization called International Consortium of Investigative Journals, they leaked this information and we call that leak as Panama Papers leak. An advocate filed a case in Supreme Court against these Indian offshore account holders, that is Indians who have shared their information to this firm. Supreme Court has directed this matter to CBI and asked CBI to conduct probe into this alleged offences under Prevention of Corruption Act and Prevention of Money Laundering Act. Where this topic can be useful? This topic can be useful in GS Paper 3, and we have a topic called money laundering and you can use this information there. The next article is Panel for Automatic Suspension in Rajya Sabha. Here, we have a small concept called question hour. Here, this panel also recommended to restore the time of question hour to 11 a.m. But we have to see what is this question hour. The first hour of every parliamentary sitting is question hour. And in this question hour, what the parliamentarians will do is, either in Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha, they will ask questions. For suppose, if a parliamentarian introduced a bill either in the Lok Sabha or in Rajya Sabha, then the remaining parliamentarians, they'll have some doubts about this bill, or they have to ask what are the implications of the bill, what are the advantages, disadvantages. Then they will ask this in this question hour to that parliamentarian. And there are different types of questions that are asked, that is starred questions, unstarred questions, and questions of short notice, and private member, that is questions to private members. In this starred questions, if anyone asks these questions, then that parliamentarian who introduced bill, for suppose, have to give oral answer. That is, there he have to give orally the answer. Then there will be chance for other parliamentarians also to ask any other doubts based on this oral answer again. And in unstarred question, just they will give a written answer and no supplementary questions follow for this written answer. And in short notice question, they'll give the question through short notice, less than 10 days, and they will also get the answer orally. And private member, we should know who is a private member in the parliament. If a member of parliament, but he is not a minister, then we call that person as private member. And if that person is introducing any bill or he passed any resolution or any other matter in the business of the house, you have to ask that person. We call that question as question to a private member. And the questions are listed. And how you differentiate these questions, whether it is starred or whether it is unstarred or whether it is a question to private member or it is a short note question, based on the colors. You'll have green, white, light pink and yellow color for these questions. That is green for starred, white for unstarred, light pink for questions of short notice and yellow for questions to private member. Try to answer today's questions. The first question is, which of the following fundamental rights are not available to foreigners? Right to life and personal liberty, right to shelter, speedy trial and right to freedom of movement. And the second question is, which strait connects Atlantic Ocean and Mediterranean Sea? Strait of Malacca, Bering Strait, Sunda Strait or Strait of Gibraltar? Thank you.